Hello. Welcome back to another episode of Critical Reactions with your host, Brian. Today, we're going to be moving on to something that's not special selections. That might excite you or it might leave you a little bit of worry. I guess either reaction is fine. As long as you stick around, listen to some music, and figure out if you like it or you don't. That's what's really important around here. So, we're going to be checking out Side Projects Week, which means anytime a band member has a primary band, which is usually the bigger one, and then they have a band on the side, or a project on the side, could be solo stuff. We're going to be looking at the stuff that they do on the side. Today's is going to be A Perfect Circle. The song is Judith. This one was presented to me by Charles Murphy. And Perfect Circle has actually come up quite a bit in the YouTube comments, so I'm pretty excited to see what's going on here. I know this is Maynard's side project from Maynard from Tool. So I'm interested in seeing where this goes, since Tool is kind of known for their progginess. And I don't know how much Maynard has to do with that. I know he's the vocalist. He's probably the lyricist as well. So it's really, really interesting to see if maybe we get some of his vocal work outside of some proggy stuff. I don't know. That's kind of where I think this is going. Let's hit this one up and see what happens. I like those bass kicks. Okay, so I have heard this before. It's been a long time. I like the alternating there between the cleans and the harshes. That was smooth on the guitar's part. Got a really nice groove. Nice little tempo switch up there. I drummer, man. Cool little slowdown there that I don't know if they went with a triplet or if that was more of a like a retardante to slow that down. All right. So, yeah, there's, it is. See, I was going to be interested most in what I said was maybe having some of the vocal work of Tool in more of a, you know, less proggy atmosphere. And I didn't get that, right? Instead, we got, okay, so Tool on this channel, we listened to the same song twice. It's Numa. And the vocals are a bit muted, I'd say. Not necessarily in the mix, but performed. There's not a lot of emphasis or emotion or power behind them, at least not that I remember. And this song, there's impactful vocals. They are just, there's a lot of emotion behind them. We got a lot of strength in them. We got a lot of volume. We got some range, both in the volume, in the dynamics, in all sorts of aspects. It's, the vocals are a lot more dynamic than they are in Numa. And I think this is a very, this is a side of the singer that I would rather see than what we checked out in Numa. I understand that his vocal work in Numa fit with the atmosphere of the song. It was about that slow buildup. It's about a lot of, you know, muted instruments coming together for a lot of layers. And it works in the context of that song, but I really like to hear, you know, stuff like this where you can tell that there's a bit of investment. I think if, nah, we're not going to go that direction. We're not going to go that direction. But I do appreciate what's going on here vocally. The drummer tearing it up, not some of the most complex stuff we've listened to, but there are some really interesting ideas in there. We have that bit, I guess close to the end, maybe about the three and a half minute mark, when we went from a halftime to a double time. We had a little bit of a tempo switch there, and there's a really cool fill going into that. We had a pretty wild fill there at the end. Just a lot of really cool stuff going on in the drums. A lot of it is kind of standard rock fare drumming, but there are some really nice fills and like tempo ideas going on in a couple of places. The guitar and bass work, they're rock fare guitar and bass stuff. Can't really say there's much interesting there. It didn't really grab me anything outside of introducing a really nice groove. And there's nothing wrong with that. This is a groovy song. It's got a nice little pocket that you can just kind of fall into and you know, nod your head. It's a chill song musically. A lot of the energy and aggression that I get out of the song comes from the vocalist. But the guitar and bass work is fairly laid back. Lots of groove to it. And I gotta say, though, the guitarist grabbing the finger slide, I don't know what the technical term for that tool is, but it's the round, it looked like he was using a plastic tube. Some people use metal tubes that you put around your finger and use it to slide up and down the neck of the guitar. The way that he picks that up and puts it back down is just phenomenal. It is one of the smoothest like instrumental. That's not, it's an instrument, not like a musical instrument, but like a tool, an instrument switch that I've ever seen. It's just like, just runs his hand over it, and it's locked on his fingers, like magnetic. I don't know how he does it, but it is smooth. Unfortunately, I will say that the picking work for me was more interesting than those slides. I do like the way the slides feel against the bass and drum, because the drum's doing some of those eighth note offbeat kicks where you get the do 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 ga do 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 ga do do, something like that. You got this little like a shuffle going on. And then you get these nice, you know, boo, and you get these very elegant legato slides. And I like what they're doing in the context of the song. But overall, it's not interesting to me. And I don't know the best way to go about talking about that off the top of my head. Because, like I said, I do really appreciate how it fits into the song. I think it adds much needed atmosphere. It just didn't click for me. Yeah, the bass work was just solid though. Props to the bassist though. The guitar's doing its thing for a second. Most of the other instruments kick out. Time to put the hair up, getting a little hot. I mean, I've done it as a bassist even. Back when I was in a rock band in my early 20s. You know, the bass drops out for 4 bars or 2 bars or whatever. That's 10 seconds. Put your hair up. And if it's hot, that hair goes straight up. You're just waiting for that pocket to do it. So, yeah, been there. Totally get it. I love that made it into the video. It has nothing to do with the music, but it is a nice little human moment. And I love my humanity, man. Humanity is really cool. And I like seeing those small human elements in performances. But yeah, for me, like I said, the takeaway, especially coming from Tool's Numa, is the vocalist here and hearing a lot more impact out of his vocal work than I had heard the last time we checked his work out. So yeah, I dig this. It's a good song. Like I did say though, when the vocals came in, I have heard this before. This is a radio song from, you know, radio rock stuff from, what, early to mid-2000s, maybe? That is the time I was a teenager starting to drive on my own, and I listened to my local radio station, and they played, you know, radio-friendly rock, mainstream rock stuff, and this is definitely that. So, yeah, I have heard this. It has been quite some time. And while some of the stuff did kick in, and I'm like, oh yeah, I remember that. I can't say I remember all of it, but I mean, there's also a bit of a difference of appreciation of a teenager who's just jamming the rock and somebody who's in their 30s who has spent a good portion of their life playing and learning about music, and I can kind of come to it from that angle now. So that's kind of cool too. Yeah. So I guess that's going to be about it for this one. Like I said, not too much interest in going in the music, but I'm really digging the vocal work. I would like to listen to more of A Perfect Circle, or if Tool has anything with this level of vocal work in it, because coming to think of it, you know, Numa didn't really hit me that hard because of the long buildup. But when we got to the drum cam and I actually got to see some of the drum work, I really appreciated that, what was going on there. It's a lot more complex than it sounded originally when I didn't have the visuals to see what was going on with the drums. And another thing that just didn't land for me was the vocals. They're very subdued. I didn't really feel like there was a lot going on in them. I try not to discount or discredit people or bands on a first listen, but, you know, the vocalist just, it didn't hit me on the first time, and I was kind of wondering, you know, is this all he's got? And I'm kind of blown away by this. I know this is much older. It was uploaded to YouTube in 2009, but this is a remastered video. So I don't know if the audio's been touched now that I think about it. But I would assume that this was uploaded after it originally came out. But still, we're talking at least 10 years here. Much earlier than Numa was. So, you know, is there any earlier Tool work that has this kind of vocal work in it? I don't know. I really enjoy a lot of the passion that's coming out of this vocalist. So, yeah, you guys can hit me up in the comments. Let me know, like I said, other Tool songs or Perfect Circle tracks that are like this vocally. I'm also interested in any other musical works. This was musically a little safe for me, but you know, I'm not judging the entire band here on one song. Like I said, I try not to discredit anybody based on one song. Is there anything else that they do that's maybe a little bit more complex but retains that vocal energy? That would be something I'm really looking forward to in this band. And then, like I said, with Tool, is there anything that has this level of vocal energy, maybe while keeping that prog aspect? I'd be interested in that as well. All right, so that wraps this one up. Like I said, you can comment, let me know what you thought about this, or if there's any other recommendations from Maynard, whatever his last name is. That's pretty bad. I only know his first name. Yeah. There's also a description box with a link to the Patreon if you'd like to become part of the Patreon. You get access to the Discord community as well as voting on future bands and themes. There's also a link to blocked videos in there if you're interested in that. And we will continue tomorrow at 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 10 p.m. UTC, with more of the Side Projects Week. This was the number one voted track. Tomorrow we're going to look at the number two voted track, and then we're going to look at some random selections from the top end and the bottom end. And then Friday, as is usual from now on out, we'll be looking at my personal pick that I selected from the list, whatever interested me the most. All right, so if you guys drop back by tomorrow, fantastic. I'll see you then. If not, that's cool too. Have a fantastic morning, afternoon, or evening. Stay safe out there and keep being awesome.